Hi, welcome to automationtesting.in. In this video, we will see create Cucumber Maven project in IntelliJ IDEA. In our previous video, we have seen that how to add Cucumber plugin and Gherkin plugin in IntelliJ. So in this video, we will see how to create a Maven project for Cucumber in IntelliJ IDEA. So let's go to IntelliJ. So this is my welcome screen of IntelliJ IDEA. So in the left side, you see projects. So I'll click on this projects. And then I'll click on new project. So it will take some time. Yeah, you see that you'll find new project window. And the left side, you have options like Java, Maven, Gradle, and JavaFX, Android, something like that. So I'm interested in Maven. So Maven here. The default Java version which I installed, it will take from this project SDK. So I'm not taking any archetype, default archetype. I'm just clicking next. So here in the Z drive, automation folder, Cucumber folder, Cucumber projects. Inside this Cucumber projects, I need to create a project. So I'll name it as Cucumber tutorial. Okay, I'll name it as Cucumber tutorial. So you see artifacts coordinates. So the group ID. So the name of the artifact group, usually a company domain. So that should be in the reverse order of, instead of example.org, it's org.example. And the same way, our website is automationtesting.in. So I'll say in dot, instead of automation testing, I'll say AT short form. And then artifact ID, the name of the artifact within the group, usually a project name. So the project name I'm mentioning, Cucumber tutorial, right? I'll just click on finish. So now it will take some time to open the window and to show the project. So it's preparing the workspace. So here you can see that if you see here, scanning files indexes. So it will take some time to index your all the files. And then here tip of the day, so that we already seen. So I'll close this. And in the left side, you see that the project, you can see Z automation, Cucumber, Cucumber projects and Cucumber tutorial. So this is my project. And it is still some downloading plugins related to Cucumber, all those things. Cucumber tutorial means the project related plugins, it is downloading. So in the left side, when you expand this Cucumber tutorial, you'll find SRC source folder. And when you expand this, you'll have main, source main and source test. And when you expand main, you'll find Java and resources. If you expand test, you'll find Java. Project, this is the default project structure. So apart from that, the heart of your Maven project is pom.xml. You see that pom.xml. So it is created, and here group ID is in.at, and the artifact ID is Cucumber tutorial, right? So now, if I want to work with Cucumber, I need some dependencies to work with Cucumber. Dependencies with some jar files. So what are those, right? So if you're not sure what to take as dependencies, so go to google.com and just search Cucumber Java POM skeleton. Okay, Cucumber Java skeleton or Cucumber POM skeleton, something like that. So when you search like this, and this will be the link like github.com. So first just click on this. Here you can see some basic structure skeleton of your pom.xml to work with Cucumber. You see that some properties and some dependencies. Inside the dependencies, Cucumber Java, Cucumber JUnit, and JUnit. And apart from that, some plugins. Those are Maven compiler plugin and Maven Surefire plugin. So we need all these things. So what I'll do, first I'll copy some properties from here. and I'll go to my IntelliJ. So I already have some properties. So before that, I'll just paste all my these dependencies. So here Java version, it is saying 1.8, but my Java version is 15. So I'll just update that. So let me update that, the 15, and JInit version 4.13.2, and the Cucumber version is 6.10.1, and Maven compiler plugin 3.8.1, Surefire plugin version is 2.22.2. Okay, and Maven compiler source and Maven compiler target is 15, means Java version. Okay, so this much is enough, and go back here and need all these dependencies and plugins. So I'll copy from these dependencies to this build. Okay, I'll copy this, I'll go to my this, and it should be inside the your project tag. Okay, everything should be inside project tag. So after properties, I'll just paste my dependencies. In these dependencies, you see that Cucumber, Cucumber Java, Cucumber JUnit, and JUnit. Okay, so, and I'm mentioning dollar symbol for the version and the curly braces Cucumber version. The reason is this is kind of variable or placeholder. So the version which I'm using, I'm getting from the properties, the cucumber.version. You see that this is cucumber.version and cucumber.version here also. Okay. And the same way JUnit.version. You see that JUnit.version. So when you mention like this dollar symbol and inside the curly braces, it will take that value from this properties. The reason why we'll put like this is, so Cucumber version in the two places I'm using. So if tomorrow the version changes, we need to change in two places. So instead of that, if you refer like that, if you change here in the top, then no need to change here. It will directly take from this. So because of that, we'll do like this. And initially when you do this, some of the dependencies will show in red color. So you might see if it is fresh project, you know, freshly first time you're doing JUnit version and all these things. So for that, what do you need to do? Here you see M and some refresh symbol. So just click on this. Then what you see, so here it's resolving dependencies. So it will download all the dependencies, means jar files, into your local machine. So which are needed to work with Cucumber. So it will take some time. It depends upon your internet speed. And previously, if you already installed, if you have that in your machine, then it will not take that much time. But if it is first time, it will take so much of time. So that, and I'm getting some issue. Let me check that. So I don't see anything. So something resolve dependencies, 4 errors. So I think these are not relevant to this. So now all red things are gone. Right, everything is in some bluish or white color. So if you have any errors, it will show in this file. And here you can see some no problems found, some right symbol, a very corner. But when you hover on this, no problems found. No problems found means it's all good, all jar files downloaded. Right, now I'm using Cucumber JUnit. You have option with Cucumber TestNG. So for that, you need to download TestNG. So in the initial videos, we will see with the JUnit, and as part of this video series, we will look into TestNG also, how to work with TestNG also, both. But initial stage, we'll use with JUnit and Cucumber JUnit. Okay, if you need to do that, we need to change these dependencies. That we will see when we are working with TestNG. Okay, so now we created Cucumber Maven project in IntelliJ. So now we can start writing Cucumber feature files or no, whatever it is. If you want to work with Cucumber, you are ready. Okay, so that's all in this video. Thank you for watching this video. We will see remaining topics in the upcoming videos. So if you did not subscribe to my channel, please subscribe to my channel for further updates.